Very good morning. Okay, so today we are in the last chapter of our syllabus for our course static. Okay, so this is the last chapter, which is the distributed force. Okay, distributed force, where in this chapter we will learn how to determine the centroid and also center of gravity of a composite body. Okay, so what we talk about, when we talk about composite body, it is a combination of several simple components attached together to become a composite body. For example, previously we know that, let's say we have one straight bar like this one. When we do the calculation, if there is a mass, we will put directly mg at the center of gravity, which is, we assume it is right in the middle, so mg. Okay, so if it is around like this one, we know that it is here, mg, so we have also several of this one, mg. Okay, so previously, directly when we have the component, which is a component like this one, we call it as a uniform component like this one. Okay, so we directly we can put the G is at the center of gravity. But what happened if we have this component, first, second component, and at the end we have this one. Okay, let's say we have this component. Okay, we know that for each and every component, we can determine where is the centroid or center of gravity, which is this one. We have G of the component 1, G of component 2, G of component 3. Okay, we know the position of the center of gravity for each and every component, but where is the center or centroid for the whole component? For the, this is what we call as a composite body. Okay, for this composite body, where is the center of gravity? Okay, where is the center of gravity or centroid of this one? Maybe it is here, or it is here, or it is here. So where? So in this chapter, we want to determine this one, which is to determine the position of centroid and center of gravity of a composite body. Okay, so when you talk about a composite body, it can be in terms of only line. So maybe there is several lines attached together. So where is the centroid? Okay, or we have this one, area, or we have also maybe it is a volume, something that in three dimension. Okay, so we have maybe this one, several component. Okay, so we have several component. We need to determine centroid and center of gravity of this composite body, either in only line or two dimension or in three dimension. So this is the focus of this chapter. Okay, so before we go further, we look at this one. What is centroid or what is center of gravity? Centroid and center of gravity can be the same point, can be different. Okay, so centroid is referred to the center of the shape, which is the area of that component. Whereas the center of gravity is the center of mass. It's not referred to the shape of the component. Okay, this one is referred to the shape, this one is referred to the mass. So what we mean by this one is, if we have one component like this one, homogeneous component, only one material, for example, homogeneous component, you call it homogeneous in what? A uniform thickness and homogeneous, meaning that the thickness from here to there is same, inside it is same material, and it is homogeneous. Okay, there's no hole somewhere or something else. So in this case, if you put it right in the middle, okay, if you put it right in the middle, here, there, or somewhere, you find the balance. This balance is actually, maybe it is here, this balance, okay, this, if you put the balance like this one, okay, the point where the component balance, this is the center of gravity. There is a center of gravity because it's referred to the center of the mass. Okay, but since this component is homogeneous, okay, the center of the shape, which is centroid, will be here. Because it is homogeneous, we have to put it here, half from here, half from this side, which is also at this point, the C. So in this case, for a component which is homogeneous, a uniform shape, the center of gravity and also the centroid will be at the same point. Okay, so what happened here now? If we have, okay, component, same component, but we, this is actually not homogeneous, it is a uniform but different material. Okay, so let's say this is aluminium. Okay, this is cast iron. Two different material attached together. The shape is uniform. Okay, the shape is uniform. So of course, if the shape is uniform, if you want to find the centroid, it must be right in the middle of the component. This is the C. Okay, C of that one. But if you want to find the balance here, to find the center of gravity, it might not be here. If this is far more heavier than this part, even though it is smaller, because it is heavier, maybe the center will be here, the center of gravity. Okay, the center of gravity might be here, center of gravity. If you put a balance here, you see I have these two components, different material. This part is different than this one, even though it is homogeneous. You will see that the balance point will be not exactly at the middle. Okay, so it might be here. So in this case, the centroid and center of gravity will not be at the same point. So that's the two case. Okay, so the centroid, we just look at the shape of the component. We put it in the middle of the shape. Simple. But the center of gravity, it really refer to the mass of the component. If, let's say, another example, and maybe this one will make it clear. If this is a perfect round, okay? But if I have this one right in the middle, this will be the C, the centroid. But let's say this shape, there is a hole here, hole somewhere, or half of it is attached by other component here. Now in this case, the center of gravity will be no longer in this point. It will shift somewhere. So you have to find the center of gravity. Okay, so that's two different things, centroid and the center of gravity of the component. Okay, but most of the question that we have in this book, okay, or covered in our syllabus, will mention that the component is homogeneous, uniform shape. Okay, so that in this case, we will cover at the end, we will come back to this one. Homogeneous and uniform shape, so you will see that the centroid and the center of gravity is at the same point. It can be different, but most of our question will refer back to this one, when it said the component is homogeneous and uniform. Okay, we will refer back to this one, which is center and centroid at the same point. Okay, so this one is only for one component. So the question is, what happens if we attach several components together? Where is the position of centroid and center of gravity for that component? Okay, that particular component. Okay, so one way to determine, we will determine that using the calculation, because most of the question we will set up for you the simple one, which is we will give you the basic part. Okay, that the body, okay, that will give to you, it is a combination of several simple parts which you know the position of the center of energy body. Okay, so to determine where is the location, you just need to go to the equation and calculate, you get the answer. Okay, we will not give you the shape, which is basic shape, you didn't know what is the value, the position. Okay, so anyhow, there is if you have the shape which is not common shape, no, this one you call it as a common shape, just a bar, a round, or a triangle, like this one, we call it as a common shape. If this is not in the common shape, we at least can determine where is the centroid and center of gravity using experiment. For example, there is a simple experiment to show that one. To determine the centroid and center of gravity. So let's say I have this component. I want to determine where is the centroid. The shape is something. It is not a just perfect shape, so you cannot say it is right in the middle because it's not a perfect one. Okay, so you need to determine where is the centroid or center of gravity of this the centroid for this part. Okay, so there is one method. It is explained in your book. I just want to show quickly how this can be used. Let's say we have this one. Okay, so what we need to is just put the component hanging. Okay, we will free hanging, and then we put one line here. Okay, so the component will hang like this one freely. Okay, and then after that, I will take something. Let it hang free. So I have first line. Okay, other part, other point. Just go hanging freely. Okay, and then you have the point. The other one. Should be hanging freely, right? This is actually got something stuck here. Okay, it's stuck. Okay, so it is somewhere here. So if you continue this one, you might find that it is it will give you one point actually, okay, which is that middle point. This is the point where the line intersect each other. So this point is the centroid, which is the center of the shape and the center of gravity of the shape. And because this point, okay, this shape is homogeneous and uniform shape, meaning that there's same here. It's not that we have the different thickness from here and the other thickness here. No, same thickness, okay, same thickness, uniform inside. So the centroid and the center of gravity will be at the same point. Okay, same point. Normally, if you do the balance, it will be perfectly balanced here, right in the middle. Okay, kurang gitulah. Okay, because there is a one behind, so I cannot balance this one. Okay, normally it become balanced right in the middle. Okay, the point where we find the centroid and center of gravity of this component. That's how you measure where is the centroid and center of gravity using the experiment for a non-common shape. We call it a non-common shape because it's not the three or four type of shape that I've shown you before. Okay, so later on in our study, we will focus on the common shape attached together to become a composite body and then determine where is the centroid and center of gravity of this component. Okay, so before we go to the complex component, we'll start by the simple one. Okay, we look at the centroid for common shape or bodies. Okay, so the most common one will be this shape, round one, and a triangle, perfect triangle like that one. Okay, so we have three common one, and we have several more which I will show you later. Okay, so we will look at one by one how to determine this one, and it is actually refer to the coordinate system. Okay, so the position will be referred to the coordinate system. Coordinate system. Okay, so for example, we have this y and x. Okay, y and x, my first example is here. Okay, so we know that for a homogeneous component like this one, the centroid will be right in the middle here. See, if the length here is a, so will be here the distance will be A over 2, if this is B, so this one will be B over 2. A and B over 2. Okay, so you will be right in the middle. Okay, so in this case, we have, this is the coordinate, 0, 0. The, let's say the length here is, coordinate, this is 2, this is 4, 6. This is 2, this is 4. Okay, so the centroid of this part must be here right in the middle. We refer to this coordinate, so the centroid in this case, which is, will be, the centroid here will be in X, which is 2, in Y is also 2. And we will call this part, okay, the distance from this coordinate 0, 0 to the centroid in X direction, we call it as X bar. To Y direction will be Y bar. Okay, we use the coordinate system, meaning that the coordinate can also be negative location. Okay, so second example, I'm having this same shape, but now I'm putting this here. Okay, put it here. So we know that this is the C, this is 2, let's say this is 3, okay, the 2 is here, 1, 2, 3, and this is what the distance, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, 4, 5, okay, so we need to find the C. So in this case, we know that the X bar is from here to there. So this is X bar, and the Y bar is from this point to this one, Y bar. So the X bar in this case is, this is 1 plus 3, so 4. The Y bar is equal to 4, supposed to be 4. 3, 4, so 2, okay, so 2, doesn't matter. So the Y bar in this case is half from here, is 1. So this C, in this case, is 4, 4, 1. Okay, 4, 1. Okay, 4, 1. Okay, so now I have, so meaning that this here is 2, this here is 2. Okay, so next I'll have one more here. But the component is here. This is 2, this is 2. The length is 2. But to this point, this is 1, this is 2. 1, this is also 2. Good. Now, determine the centroid for this part. Okay? So we need to always refer to this coordinate, center, to X, which is going this way. We know that it is right in the middle here. Good. So this is the X bar. In this case, this is 2. Plus, this is 2, so half of this one must be the C, half is 1. So 2 plus 1, so this is equal to negative 3, because now we're referring to the coordinate, this is 0, positive direction, positive this one, so this direction will be negative 3. So Y, from here to this point, downward, Y bar is equal to 1, 2, plus this is half from here, so equal to negative 3. So the C from this one is negative 3, negative 3 in this case. Okay, so I hope that's clear for you how you put it in the coordinate system for the centroid of simple component like this one. Okay, you want to always refer to the 0, 0, which is our reference point. Okay, so it can become positive and also negative, depend on the position of this one. Okay, so next, second shape will be, we have there a round shape or a triangle. Okay, so second one. You which is for this one, the shape. Okay, so the C is here, which is here is, let's say, the length of overall part here is what is it? Is B. So here it is, the length here is 1 over 3B, and here is also, if this length is A, so 1 over 3A. Okay, so 1 over 3A and 1 over 3B measured from this point. This one to here is 1 over 3B, this one to here is 1 over 3A. Okay, so there's the distance. So let's say we have this position, first one. Okay. So what is the distance? Here is the length here is 2, the length here is 3, and the height here is, let's say we have what also 2. Okay? Height of this component is 2, here is 3. Even though I have to really put it like this one up here. Okay, so this is 2 and this is 3. Okay, so find the X bar and Y bar in this case, which is the centroid. Okay, one more thing before I forgot, we always refer to each and every component. The direction of X is X bar, direction of Y is Y bar. We use the small x and small y, and later on we'll have big x and big y. Okay, when it referring to the composite body, the whole component. Okay, adding all the small bar, x bar and y bar for each and every component, it become the big one, and the y also become the for the big one. Okay, so the big x and y is referring to the composite material, to the composite body. The X and Y small refer to each and every component, like this one. Okay, so this one, find the centroid and center of gravity of this one. We know that it is here. Okay, it is here, which is 1 over 3. This is 1 over 3. Okay, 1 over 3 times, the length is 2. And here is also 1 over 3, the length is 3. Okay, but the location is here actually. Okay, this is the part. Okay, see. But we want to write our X bar and Y bar, the centroid, referring to this 0, 0 point. Okay, so in this case, the X bar is actually from here to this point. Okay, so which is, here we know it is 2. So 2 plus here, we didn't know, but this part we know. Okay, so it is actually, the whole part is 3. So 3 minus this small part, 3 over 3, which is this one. So it is 2, this is 1, 3 minus 1 equal to 2, 2 plus 2 equal to 4, the X bar. And we go to the Y bar, which is here, from here to there. So it is directly this one, so Y bar equal to 2 over 3. Okay, so the centroid will be 4 2 over 2 over 3. Okay, let's say I have the same part here, but I will turn it around. Now it is here, same part. Okay, this length is also 2, this length is also 3, this one is 2, C also 2. So we have the C, which is here, 1 over 3 from this line, 1 over 3 from this line. Okay, so in this case, this is your X bar, which is X bar equal to 2 plus, okay, 1 over 3 times the length of it, of the whole component, for the whole distance length is 3. So this is, which is equal to 1 plus 2, which is 3. And the Y bar, which is from here to this one, And it is equal to 1 over 3 times. So your C is equal to 3/2. Okay, so you have to write it in terms of coordinate. Everything there will be positive. If it is somewhere here, the Y will be negative. If it is here, the X will be negative, Y positive. If it is here, both will be negative. Okay, so that's the coordinate location. Okay, so I think that it is clear for the simple shape. So we have these two, I'll show you two. And the other one, we have this round here, which is the CG is at the center here. Okay, so it is R. So right in the middle will be your C and your G. Okay, and there is several other simple component. And it is written in the book here, given to you. Okay, you can refer to this one. There are several more. Okay, this one, rigid body, the upper part, okay, that I'm showing you here, shaded in gray will be for area, which is this one. The lower part here is only for the line. That's the difference. Okay, the lower part, which is here, just talking about the line, not the shape itself. This is only the line, whereas this is the area. The shaded one is the area. Okay, so you can have this one. And then put it in the in term of coordinate system. You can to have the answer for the simple component, centroid of the simple and common component. Okay. Later on, we combine these several component to become a more complex component and to determine where is the centroid.